issues. I would imagine the treatment of seizures and epilepsy becomes an important issue for most people, more so perhaps than the classification systems and some of the kind of medical scientific aspects of epilepsy. But
thank you. 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 I risk of significant morbidity and death. So that those rates have been studied before and after with patients that have had surgery, not the risk of death goes down. So everything gets better after successful epilepsy surgery. So, but it's important to get right.
I can share with you as a mother and as a member of, I think I'm in over five or six Facebook groups of parents of children who have had epilepsy surgery. A pediatric epilepsy surgery group is about 1,900 parents. Hemispherectomy alone is 2,200 parents. My son's condition is extremely rare, but we have over 600 parents in that group. The general message is that most parents say that they wish they had had this surgery sooner. Very few that I know of regret it. It's in the low, low percentages. And most of those are children who, I think it's because they have different expectations of outcomes than what the surgeon explained. I can say candidly that sometimes the surgeons give you an outcome that is maybe not really what your kid's gonna get, but at the same time, it's so much better than what uncontrollable seizures do. So like for, obviously I'm not proposing hemispherectomy because it's a big procedure, but the vision loss and the hemiparesis, for all of the parents I talked to, pales in comparison to how quickly the children were progressing prior to surgery and how poor the quality of life was. So very, very few.